Hi guys, I'm Ahmed, and today I'm here with question number 32 from recalls of HAD, MOH and DHA. Let's read the question with a smile. A 34 years old patient presented with high grade fever for a few days. He has joint pains, extreme fatigue. After investigations, you found that he is having brucellosis. You are sending CSF culture. What precautions will you take? Okay. Option A is freeze the CSF before sending to lab. Option B is alert the lab when sending sample. Option C is do blood culture again with it. Option D is bone marrow culture is must with it. This is regarding investigations of brucella. And let's have few words about brucellosis investigations. Okay, first thing is that we need culture for definitive diagnosis of brucellosis, and gold standard is blood culture. You can do also urine culture, bone marrow culture, CSF culture, and even bone marrow aspirate can be used to test. When the disease is generalized, bone marrow culture is top of the list. And if the disease is localized to some area, then you have to do the culture of that area. Regarding blood culture, you have to remember one point that as we have already discussed that there are four types of brucella that can infect humans. Blood culture yield for every type is different, okay? Like for militensis, it's around 80%, 75 to 80%, and for abortus it's nearly 60%. So blood culture yield is different for all four types. For bone marrow culture, regarding bone marrow culture is not a routine culture test in this scenario. We do this test when patient has already taking or started on antibiotics, then we can add blood culture, bone marrow culture to blood culture. Okay. For CSF culture, when there is CNS involvement, we will do the lumbar puncture and send CSF culture. One term used for this is neurobrucellosis, and CSF culture yield for this is around 30%. Okay. When it is positive, our treatment will be based on this. Then we have to wait for until this culture is negative. Okay. We will discuss the treatment of this in probably next question. And fifth option is the person who are taking the samples, either it's nurse or some other helper, they are prone to be infected by this, and lab should be alerted for this, and the test should be done with specific biosafety measures. Okay. Serology, especially in endemic areas, serology is very important, and if it takes several weeks to get positive, but when it's there, it's it can detect up to 95% cases. And when we will say it's positive, when the titer or titer, both pronunciation are correct, when the titer is 1 by 320 in a single test, or there is 4-fold raise in the titer. Okay. So this was regarding the brucellosis investigations. We will go back to the question now. Okay. Option A, freeze the CSF before sending to lab. No, there is nothing mentioned like this in our data. And second one is alert the lab when sending sample. Yes, because we know that it can infect the persons working there. So they have to do some biosafety measures. So we should alert the lab when we are suspecting brucella. Okay. Do blood culture again with it. as you remember the last sentence, we are sending CSF culture, and he's asking that do bone marrow culture again with it. No, it's not necessary. If you have already done blood culture, then you don't have to repeat it with CSF culture. Bone marrow culture is must with it, and we know that bone marrow culture is not a routine test. It is done when the patient is already on antibiotics. So the option B is correct. So this is all about this scenario. See you soon with another scenario. Till then, subscribe the channel and take care.